Actually, the minister gave a statement on the broader picture. I thought the panel was going to be mostly about transport infrastructure projects, but let's have this broader discussion because this is very meaningful. I think we are at a very crucial point at the moment. It's a turning point for the Greek economy, because if you see what happened in this country the last 10 years, we had a tremendous crisis which evolved from a fiscal crisis to a production crisis. And then the last couple of years we had of course, as the whole world, the health crisis with COVID. And now the next stage of this crisis, let's say, the one that we will be facing in the coming months, is the energy crisis. So these are challenges that are very, very crucial for the Greek economy. A Greek economy starting from a very low point, but at the same time, it provides the opportunity to do what should be done decades ago, and that's the transformation of the production model of the country. If we continue in the same way, and unfortunately I have to say that the latest reforms by the government in terms of the labor market, in terms of the policy on pensions, in terms of the environmental policy, do not predict a very positive effect on this transformation. It's mostly, I would say, a recycling of policies that failed 10 years ago. If we don't transform this production model now, then we will be facing with a situation where we will again be lagging against the other European countries. But what do we mean by transformation? Because this is a very vague term, and it could include anything and everything and everyone. I think we have to be a bit more specific. So I would highlight three key challenges. One, of course, is tackling the climate crisis. But the climate crisis and the transition to a new, greener production model will have winners and losers. And this is what's happening now in Greece and abroad with the energy crisis. We are seeing that the majority of the economy, we're seeing that the SMEs, we're seeing that the households are paying for a very badly planned transition to a green model. Of course, we need to achieve our goals. Of course, we need to even go beyond the Paris targets in terms of greening the economy. The latest report from the IPCC predicts that we are already beyond the tipping point for the climate crisis. But this has to be done in a way that will be inclusive to the society and the economy. At the moment, countries like Greece and economies like the Greek economy are struggling to adapt to this new situation. So we need policies that will get our companies, our SMEs especially, we get our households on board on this transition. And this can only be done if we have policies that support these parts of the society that are currently struggling. So one is the climate crisis, green transition. Second, very important issue is inequalities in a broader sense. We have at the moment many parts of the economy that cannot adapt not just to the green transition, but to the digitalization of the production model, to the new ways that business is conducted, to the new COVID challenges. Unless we have policies in order to tackle that, in order to get companies, in order to get enterprises on board this new plan, and this can only be done with targeted projects and targeted programs for these particular areas, for example, what's happening with tourism and the transformation of our model in tourism, what's happening with other sectors of the economy, with the agricultural economy in Greece, what's happening with manufacturing, which needs specific projects in order to try to adapt in the new reality, then the inequalities will be higher in Greece in the coming years. And the third challenge, I see we are The time is running, so I'll be very, very brief. The third challenge is the production of domestic added value. We cannot afford to keep being a country of imports. In the last few years, 3 or 4 years, one of the main, let's say, drivers for the return to growth from 2017, 2018, was the increase in exports. But this has to be done in a sustainable way. So we need specific policies in order to support a more extrovert economy, in order to get more companies within this plan. Yesterday we had a meeting with the business community of Thessaloniki, for example, and we were told by the organization of the export companies that only the 10% of the companies export the 90% of goods and services. Unless we tackle that, unless we find ways to get more companies on board in order to be able to benefit from a more open economy, then again, we have many issues on how our production bases can be broadened and how our companies can benefit from all this huge transformation that is happening at the moment in the global economy. So these three key challenges for me are the ones that have, that should be addressed at the moment: climate crisis, domestic added value, and the tackling inequalities. I don't see a plan at the moment, and I'm very, very skeptical about the government plan on the RRF. There's a lot of criticism from the business community about how they will benefit from it, but we are here and we'll see what happens in the coming months, and we will always have very concrete and realistic proposals on how things should be changed in order to tackle those challenges. Thank you very much.